the heart of every Catholic church in the world is found the altar and the tabernacle. The Second Vatican Council happily reminds us that it is from the altar, Christ's sacrifice, and his real presence among us, that the entire mission of the Church flows. The mission renewed in the celebration of every Mass. It is the mission on which we are reflecting together in Shrewsbury Diocese, making 2017 a year for mission. Here, you and I come as truly as the woman of Samaria in the Gospel to a meeting with Christ himself and find the true worship that Jesus had promised would extend far beyond the mountains of Samaria and even the holy city of Jerusalem. For the Eucharist is the sacrifice of the cross, perpetuated through the ages, whereby in those beautiful words of the Second Vatican Council, Christ associates us with himself in this great world, wherein God is perfectly glorified and men are sanctified. A worship infinitely surpassing the offering of those who rededicated the temple of Jerusalem, as the Book of Maccabees recounted for us, who fell down prostrate in adoration, praising him to the skies. And it is here we are invited weekly, daily, to repeat those words of our Lord in the letter to the Hebrews. Here I am coming to do the Lord. Tonight the blessing and rededication of this altar recalls the vital mission entrusted here to come. Recalling that the mission of the entire church depends on the hidden life of prayer and penance, a deeply Eucharistic life. It is a reality which can be poorly understood, even amongst Catholics, that in the silence of this house is found what sustains the whole of our mission. And I hope this beautifully carved reredos, carefully and lovingly reassembled from the Carmel of St. Helens, will serve both sisters and all who visit their chapel a call to renewed faithfulness to this mission entrusted here to come. I want to record our profound gratitude to the Archdiocese of Liverpool, to the priests and people who have travelled from St. Helens this evening, and to the generous benefaction which has allowed this part of the heritage of Carmel to be recovered and find a new home amongst the Carmelite sisters for whom it was commissioned more than a century ago. This reredos connects us with the remarkable family, Mother Mary of Jesus, who founded 33 Carmelite monasteries across the British Isles and will serve as a constant, visible call to fidelity. record our thanks to all of the priests who have so generously come forward to ensure the Eucharistic life continues every day for this monastery, and all who come to share its mission of prayer. For it is at this altar that the Carmelite mission is daily fulfilled. And in the hours of silent prayer, and in the songs of the divine office prayed aloud, you hear extend the praise offered in the Eucharistic sacraments throughout the hours of the day and the night. St. John Vianney once remarked that if we were not moved to give ourselves, to offer our lives in union with this Eucharistic sacrifice and Christ's self-giving in this sacrament of his love, then we should be pitied beyond all creatures. It is a response we see visibly manifest from the impoverished shanty towns of refugee camps of the world's the greatest cathedrals and most ancient basilicas, where we see how the Christian faithful have always been moved to give of their very best in worship and in everything connected with the holiness. It is the Mass and the reality of the Eucharist which has inspired some of the greatest works of art and architecture and the finest music, giving witness to a deeper reality that, as we are taught in the Gospel, where our heart is, there our treasure will be there too. I reminded the sisters recently how St. John Mary Vianney, who lived a life of intense personal poverty, demanded that only the very best should be provided for anything connected with the Eucharistic sacrifice and sacrament. Nothing on this earth could be too good in his mind. And so for anyone who comes to know the reality of the Eucharist, only the best can ever be given. It was no doubt a nightmare for the church suppliers, who sought to provide the very best that could be found for the tiny church of ours and its altar, and always heard the constant refrain of the cure, "Not good enough, not good enough." Love demands the very best of us, and tonight in Carmel, we have sought to provide the best, with all the beauty and the noblest simplicity the sacred liturgy demands. May this altar and the reredos restored be such a visible mark of our love and the promise of our faithfulness for all the years to come. Amen. O God, our refuge and our strength, hear the prayers of your church, for you yourself are the source of all devotion, and grant, we pray, that what we ask in faith, we may truly obtain, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord our God, who accepted the sacrifice of Christ, offered on the altar of the cross for the salvation of the world. Now with the Father's love, you call your people to celebrate his memory by coming together at this time. May this altar which we have built for your holy mysteries be the center of our praise and thanksgiving. May it be the table at which we break the bread which gives us life, and drink the cup which makes us one. May it be the fountain of the unfailing waters of salvation. Here may we draw close to Christ, the living stone, and in him grow into a holy temple. Here may our lives of holiness become a pleasing sacrifice to your glory.
Blessed be God forever.
bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual
their homage to you, the eternal James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Demas, Titus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John, Paul, Cosmas, David, and all your saints. We ask through their merits and prayers in all things from you defended by your protecting them.
Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously, accept this oblation of our sins, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who are called to sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Save this man and hold him on your mind. make you abound in heavenly blessings.
Amen.
May God, who has willed that all his scattered children be gathered in his Son, grant that you may become his temple and the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May you be made thoroughly clean, so that God may dwell within, and you may possess with all the saints the inheritance of eternal happiness.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you.